Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Praise the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. You know, this is the only service I know watu wanakuanga wapole. But if I meet you outside there, nasukanga. So, praise the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. My name is Rispa Wakari. More to that, I'm saved. I love God as my personal savior. I'm a youth. This is Nairobi. I'm a female. So, I'll be sharing with you the word very briefly because of time. And open with me the book of Mark. Mark, it's in the New Testament. Mark chapter 11, from verse 22 to 25. But I'll use 24 as my platform this morning, so allow me to read very quickly. Mark chapter 11, verse 24, and it says, "Therefore I say to you, whatever things you ask, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them." Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes, and this morning I want us to speak about prayer. Prayer. And prayer is a very wide topic. It's very wide. Mnanyamaza vizuri. You make me feel as if I'm teaching mathematics. So, prayer is very wide, but every person has his or her own level of prayer. So prayer life varies from one person to another. One else as if you. So maybe just to define what prayer is simply communication. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible calls us bride. One else as if you. And wherever there is a bride, I assume there is also a groom, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And in order for there to be a relationship, we must have a communication. So prayer is simply communication. So who are communicating? Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So communication with God. It's communication with God. It's communication with spirit. So I'll elaborate on communication with spirit maybe later on as we go on. So prayer is simply communication with God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So in many verses we find that God is referred to as a listener. Kuna some verses in the Bible that says, "Call unto me and I'll listen." Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Open it with Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 12 very quickly. Jeremiah 29, verse 12, and I read, "Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you." Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says, you pray to me and I will listen. Here we find that God is telling us that he will listen. But the question is, do we talk? I'm really talking too much. Turn to your neighbor and ask him or her, do you talk?
Ukiona mtu wa kujibu ama anakuangalia kiwa serious, ni yeye tunaongelelea, haongeaki na Mungu.
Or when you talk to God is when things zimetan kuwa messy. When you feel like you have no one else to turn to. That's when you remember, okay, kuna mtu. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So prayer is communication with God. How many times do we communicate to God? How many times do we talk to him? Hata kuna watu wananunua mahindi kwa barabara and they don't pray. Unakula tu mahindi na mwenye amechoma hiyo mahindi anavuta sigara. Yeye hapo tu hapo na kigoza yake anapepeta mahindi. You just buy mahindi and just eat without praying. Hallelujah. Unanunua mandazi unakula. Some of us don't even pray when we are going to sleep. Unakumbukanga kuomba wakati tuko kanisani, wakati praise and worship wameomba, wameworship, and you're feeling like it's like everybody is praying, and that's when you remember our Father. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So the Bible says that he will listen, but my question this morning is, do you talk? So the Bible calls us the bride, and definitely we have a groom, and in any normal relationship, kama kuna communication, unashita. Bonesho sipiwe. We have men or dads here who are married. The moment you enter in the house and the mom is not talking to you, unajuanga kimeumanga. For us who are in relationship, if you have your guy and he's not talking to you, jua kuna shida. So even us, we call ourselves brides, and our grooms are there and we are not talking to him. Kuna shida. Bwanesu wasifiwe. Hallelujah. I won't tell much of that, but I'll write us to go to Psalms 62, verse 8. Psalms chapter 62, verse 8. I'll be very quick. And it says, trust in him all the time, you people. Pour out your hearts before him. God is a refuge for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, I'd like us to talk briefly on that. So some of us, maybe we don't talk to God because we feel that the circumstances we are in are beyond repair. Mwe fika yo situation yenye unaangalia unashindwa sasa nitajielezaje. How do I even start? Where do people start? And you feel like this situation is beyond repair. It's like a prodigal son that went and wasted himself there, akajiwesta. And when you're in that situation, you ask yourself, how am I going back home? Ushaitumu wa duka, ulikuwa umezoea, ukienda kwa duka kununua mafuta ni gatibo. So you're used to it. Na juu ni kwa kerosene pack, unaweza mwambia hata kuwekea 25. So one day, you go to the kerosene pub and you tell the guy he care 25. Unakula hiyo 5 bowl. So it becomes a routine. And then one day, unaanzia kukula 5 bowl kabla uja, fika kwa kerosene pub. And when you get there, you find that the guy amefunga. And that's when you ask yourself, how am I going back home? Na vile mama atanicharaza. So we find ourselves in that circumstances where you've wasted yourself. You've done so much and you're asking yourself, nita approach Mungu aje. So the Bible tells us in Psalms 62 verse 8, that pour out your heart to him. The Bible says that he will listen. I want us to get that point. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter the content. What matters is, he will listen. Bwanesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Am I talking to someone? So, the Bible says that he will listen. Pour out your heart. How many times have we poured our hearts out to him? Akakata kutusikiza. How many times do we go back and tell him, Father, here I come again? And akakata kutusikiza. The question is, do you even go? Do you return? Do you talk to him? There's always shake up. In any normal relationship, there must be shake-up. But the question is, do you communicate? Hello, hello. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na smile kidogo ndo tunaencourageana, mnanienkourage. Mkiwa serious sana, I'm worried. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. The question this morning is, do you communicate? Okay, nimi no communicating. My apologies. So if you communicate, are your prayers answered? Praise God. When you communicate to God, maybe most of us, we do pray. We do pray. We go to him every morning. In the noon, we are there. In the afternoon, we are there. In the evening, we are there. Midnight, we're still there. We are talking to him. But you get responses. Unajua kuongea ni is a thing, na kupata response is another. I might talk to you, but if you don't respond, if I don't get responses, then that is not communication. You might be listening, but if I don't get communication back, tunaitanga rumadio in that language. You're talking to someone and they don't talk back to you. Hapo ndio unagongana kofi. Hallelujah. So the question is, maybe you pray. Maybe you appear to God every now and then. My question is, you get responses. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bonyeso asifiwe. My question is, do you get responses? There must be responses. If there is communication, communication is you talk, you listen. You talk, I listen. There must be communication. Am I making sense? So some of us, we may be praying, but we are not getting our answers. And sometimes you ask yourself, where am I going wrong? I've been praying for something for so many years. I've been praying for something for years, coming, come out, and I'm not getting responses. I'm not getting what I have, I want. And the Bible is telling me, you will listen. So I believe if you're listening, lazima kukuwe na response. Hata kama si kwa mdomo nikusikie, I must see some signs. Hallelujah. You might be talking to someone, women, we have an attitude that you're talking to us and we sneer. That's a response. So wako umejua, kameumana. But if you talk to me and I don't respond, unajulizana na ni nini sisemi vizuri. Ni wapi siongei vizuri. Ni wapi hapaendi vizuri. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So every time you pray, there must be a response. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So open with me in the book of James, chapter 1, verse 6. James, if you're there, say amen. The book of James, are we there? James chapter 1 verse 6. And I read, but when you pray, you must believe and not doubt at all. Whoever doubts is like a wave in the sea that is driven and blown about by the wind. Praise God. So I want us to look on some things that make our prayers not get answered. And one is doubt. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. You might be a very good prayerful person. You might be, wewe ni ule unaombaga watu unajitemeka. But after you pray, you pray, you pray, you pray, you wake up there and you ask yourself, will he really do it? You find that you're there, you're praying for a car. And you pray, you pray, you pray, na kama unajiona ukidrive. And then when you say amen, unajiuliza, na sasa najusina pesa, hiyo gari natoka wapi? You see where we contradict things. You're praying very well, but you're doubting God. The God who made manna rain down like rain, vile mnaona mvua ikinyesha, he's able to do it. But our problem is to pray very well. Unaanzia maombi vizuri na una conclude vizuri. But after you're there, shetani naye ni nani? Analeta msee. Ana kudemoralize. Umewahi kuwa demoralized? Unakuwa demoralized mpaka unasikia hapana. So you start doubting God. And that's when you find that Jesus at some point, he said, go behind me, Satan. Jua nijua akialao hii kitu ikute before him, ata doubt. So at some point in our lives, we pray, we pray, we pray. And because the devil won't allow you to get that blessing, he'll bring something in front of you. He'll bring doubts. And the Bible says when you have doubt, you're just like, you're being tossed. Wala gilo, kunakuma na upepo. Mti inenda hivi, inarudi hivi, inenda hivi, inarudi hivi. You are not standing. Uko, aneza fanya, asifanya. Have you been in that position where unaambia mtu? Utakunywa soda. Alafu mtu anakuuliza, sasa wewe unibaiye. Wewe sasa. You see that person is doubting you. So hata kama ulikuwa utoe pesa, unarudisha pesa wapi? Kwa mfuko. Why? Because the person doubted. So that's what the Bible is telling us this morning. That you might pray for something. Na wakati inaweza kufika heaven, una doubt, hivyo ndio inafungwa. Hallelujah. So that's point number one. Point number two is wrong motives. We pray, yes, but we pray for wrong motives. Open with me the book of James, chapter 4. chapter 4, verse 3. And I read, and when you ask, you do not receive it because your motives are bad. You ask for things to use for your own pleasures. Bonesu asifiwe. Unaomba vizuri, lakini unaomba ndio umilingie. Ama unaomba waste. Sasa wewe nikuulize, nikukuuliza tu, nikuulize. Unaweza omba Mungu 10k ya kwenda kukunywa kupe? Haya nikukuuliza tu. Wewe unaona nazi. Unaweza omba Mungu 10k ya kwenda kukunywa kupe? Na kuna mtu anaomba hiyo 10k ya kulipa rent. Kuna mtu anaomba hiyo 10k ya kulipia mtoto fee, alafu akupe, si ndio? Hebu touch your neighbor, ask them, do you see God doing such work? Amekujibu? Asipokujibu jua ni yeye tunaongelelea. Ni yeye. He's the one. Ukiona mtu anakuangalia serious ukimuuliza hiyo swali, he's the person you're talking about this morning. So sometimes we pray very well, but we pray for wrong motives. And this comes with those prayers are at yes. Do you know them?
Yes.
Maombi ya return to sender. Yes. Kwa nini nimekuwa serious all of a sudden? Turn to your neighbor and ask them, do you pray those prayers?
Do you pray those prayers?
What did they tell you? Do they pray? Oh. So sometimes you pray. And because somebody prayed that your husband should die, na huu narudi kwa magoti, unasema, I return that death to the owner. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Sasa nikuulize, nikuuliza tu. Wewe na Murogi, kuna difference. Because you're praying that the dead be returned back to that man. Na pengine hata huo mzae ajui. Ajui kitu mnakuanga na yeye na huo hivi. You two women, unatumia kifo kwa mtu na yeye ana return back. So you see, you're killing innocent people. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So kuna maombi yasitajibiwa. Maombi ya RTS leo tumeivunja in Jesus' name. Hamwezi sema amen. So, mchungaji yo people here, wameshikwa. So, we pray, but we pray vile hakufai. We pray for wrong motives. Unaomba gari, ndo ukuje unyoshe nayo na maji hapa kwa barabara. Ama unipike na vumbi. Unaomba Mungu akupeka suti, ndo ukiingia hapo unaingia ni kama unaenda fashion show. Hallelujah. Yes. Najumimi sina hiyo kasuti unataka ushow off. God will not give you that deal. So stop praying for it. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Yes, another is that we do not ask from God. You know, we people, we believe that God knows it all. Yes, He does. He knows everything. But when I started, I said that this is a relationship. And so communication must be there. So you talk, I listen. Sibio? Tumesema God is willing to listen. And so no matter how much you love me, and you do not declare, unajua mimi women, tunakuanga na, tuliseme ni kubarikiwa, tulibarikiwa, tunasomanga barua, ikiwa kwa bahasha. Barua iko kwa bahasha, lakini tushaisoma. So you might be there and I know, na kimodokeri yae, kuna venue. I know, but unless you declare it, nitaishi kukua kama kazibu, but let's asipiwe. So Bible is telling us that unless you tell God, He will not do it for you. Open with me James chapter 4, hapo tu juu, verse 2, and it says, you want things, but you cannot have them, so you are ready to kill. You strongly desire things, but you cannot get them, so you quarrel and fight. You do not have what you want, because you do not ask God for it. How many times have you prayed wholesome prayers? Ile maombi ya, Father, you know all my needs, meet them in Jesus' name. Be specific. Sometimes we fail to get answers to our prayers because we ask wholesome. The same thing applies to us when we go to repent. Unaomba Baba nisamehe makosa ya kuona, ya kusikia, ya kugusa, ya kukanyaga, ya kusudia. You see those prayers. If you know you saw something that is unpleasant before the eyes of God, say, I saw some things. Father, I even said some things. Wacha kuomba watu natubu makosa ya kunena. It's about some prayers and the prayers you're talking about this morning. Sometimes you don't mention them. You don't get specific. And we fail to get answers because we do not get specific. So from today, if you're praying that, Lord, I want peace, be specific. It's this. When Hannah was praying, she said that, Lord, I want a baby and I want a baby boy. Hakuwa general. Alikuwa specific. Lord, I want a baby boy. Not just a baby, but a baby boy. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So sometimes we fail to get answers. Sometimes we fail to get what we want because we do not ask from God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So sometimes we do not get answers because we do not have faith. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And I'll go back to that platform of Mark 11. Kwambia, I use that as my platform, so don't close it. Verse 22, it says, so Jesus answered and said to them, have faith in God, and you shall tell this mountain, move from this place, and it shall move. Sometimes we do not get our answers because we pray, but we do not have faith. Sometimes it's not because you do not know God will do it. Sometimes it's because of the circumstances you find yourself in. I remember a time in my life, I was in a very difficult situation. And my mother is a very good friend of mine. Na sijui wa mama na watoto wao kuna connection. Wanatuambianga ni nadhani lakini mimi sionagi kama ni nadhani. Kuna kwa connection nyingine. So every time I'll be down, she'll call me and ask me, how are you doing? And so I told her. And she told me, do you know what you'll do? You will pray. Na wewe ukiangalia, unashindwa, una pray na uoni njia. Have you been in that situation whereby you ask yourself, what am I praying for? Not because you do not know God will listen, but because you are not seeing the way itself. Others are seeing the way, but you yourself are not seeing it. And so there was my mom and another person that the Lord had raised. And they used to call me and I would tell them, you know what I'll do? I will not limit God, but I'll walk with your faith. Because right now, in you, Imani, you see me. But I'll walk with your faith. And so every time I'll go to prayer, I'll tell God, remember there's someone standing in the gap and they have faith in you. So, and your word is telling me that those who trust in you shall never be put to shame. Because of those who are standing in the gap and they have faith in you, Lord, don't put them to shame. And so if it was me praying for myself at that moment, hakuna majibu nilipata. Why? Because I did not have faith. I never saw that hiyo barabara wanaona. Wao wanaona kuna wewe na mimi sioni. So I used to tell them, I'll walk with your faith. So at some point in life, where we are today, it's because of somebody's prayer. Sometimes you just have to entangle yourself with somebody's faith in order to move forward. Because the devil knows that uli kipe imani ya kiyoma atafanikiwa. Na wewe unakuwa mwerevu. Unajua na jumisi na hiyo imani, I'll entangle myself with somebody who has faith. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So sometimes we fail to get answers because we don't have faith. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Sometimes you do not have patience. You pray for something and you expect it to happen there. You see, maturity is when you know that your dad si kila saa atakuwa anapata kitu. Kuna wakati utamuuliza akwambie ngojea. Najua ni kibebi unaanza vurugu ukisema utajirusha kwa mchanga hata unipendi. Some prayers is the last ones. I'm sorry. Kuna last ones huku. So those are the people that wanatoka fujo na vurugu. Ati usiponipea, nitafanya, last one is very dramatic. Kitu kidogo, ataanza kusema, oh, I know you don't love me. And awatane afadhali singezaliwa huku. Oh, I'll do this. You see those kind of prayers. And sometimes we have to reach to that maturity level whereby you know that this prayer will take some time before it can answer. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. No time for dramas. No time ya kuambia Mungu ati Mungu usipolete hiyo gari sahi sahi. Mimi na backslide. Naenda kwa bali nitafute kimtu kinibaie gari. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. There is no time for that drama. You have to get mature enough to know that some things might take time to get answered. For example, you might be there praying for a husband. And you know we have this condition that I want a handsome, tall, dark, and sedumini guy. So in order to kemale Nairobi yote, hakuna. So that guy must be taken all the way from Kisumu. And in order for you people to get to know each other, lazima kuorganiziwe kesha mahali. Ndiyo mwende mupatane, mujuwane. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So sometimes you have to be patient. You ask for something and be patient. Ndiyo kitu ihappen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So we have to be patient. Another thing, you must be forgiving. And the Bible is saying in Mark
11 verse 25.
And it says, and whenever you stand, and whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him. That your Father in heaven may also forgive your trespasses. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Anytime you have, anytime you stand to pray, forgive. That also you may be forgiven. In order for your prayer to be effective, you must pray. You must forgive. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Eh, kuna vile utaenda kuomba God kuwa na grudge. And when you go there with grudge, unapelekea Mungu mashtaka na mashtaka mingi. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Yes, so we must be forgiving in order for our prayers to be effective. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Yes, I'm very grateful for this platform that was given by our vicar and the elders. And with those few, let us pray. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your word that we have heard. We thank you, King of Glory, for your ministry to us. And now, King of Glory, as your word is telling us that we are not only the hearers of my word, but also the doers. We pray that, Lord, you may cause us to adhere to your word and to do accordingly. For it is in Jesus' name we pray and we give thanks.